I was born in a family with 13 children. And I had to find a way out. So this is my younger self. And when we started to come here, that was keeping the family together. And then we expanded to a small city. And so often we have to say what they did for Steel Band. And today I want to say what Band did and still continue to do for me and my family. Yeah. After a short while, we had fairly good repertoire. We started to work, and from then on, we continued working, and we had to work very, very hard. To survive in those days, because Steel Band wasn't as popular now. And so we went through all that, and today I'm very happy. And I think I made the right choice to stay with Steel Band and make it my profession. I had some good success. I was very fortunate to be born a Trinidadian. In a country where, you know, you have so much different avenues that you would go to go if you want to play different types of music. I went through most of them. I'm not good at dancing Indian classical music. But I started as a pan man, and I said to myself that I want to make my profession. I worked towards it, and I didn't have no hobby or any other thing. When people was playing cricket, I was playing pan, writing some music, and I continued work. I never looked for anything in return. I just wanted self-satisfaction, like, you know, I was born in a poor area and from a poor family, and I just decided to work hard and satisfy myself that I would produce some music to make myself feel good. I'm very happy today that it went further than that, and I got a lot of recognition from different people. And what I want to continue doing now is to work with youths and train them in the best way I could, prepare them for a very competitive pan world later on. So I want to thank the sponsors, Mr. Kwan and Mrs. Samaroo, and all the people that worked towards this project. And thanks a million. I couldn't do this on my own, and I promise that I will continue to work as hard as possible. To make my country. Thank you.